In this short video, I'm going to show you some useful beginner and expert tips to winning rec rooms make it to midnight. First, let's talk about perk loadouts. Perks are the key to winning as a survivor and make it very difficult to play without them. There are quite a bit of overpowered perks, while the rest of them are not as useful as others, so it's important you choose the most appropriate ones. My recommended early game perk loadout choices would be Get Hyped, Brave Scout, and Signal Boost. Get Hyped is my first pick because it can save you countless times from a close bonky encounter after healing or getting healed by someone with the perk, allowing you to run very fast. The perk also stacks with other survivors who have it equipped, making you go insanely fast. Now I chose Brave Scout because this perk reveals Bonky for your entire team for 5 seconds if you are within 10 meters of him, and having your team know where Bonky is at all times is the best strategy to winning. The same goes for Signal Boost, where you can see Bonky for 15 seconds after repairing a generator, allowing you to give callouts and directions to your teammates. And my recommended late game perk loadout would be Squad Up, Escape Enchantment, and Signal Boost. Squad Up is probably the second best perk as a survivor because it boosts generator repair speed by 5% for every player on the generator, making you complete it as quick as possible if Bonky is on the other side of the map. So Escape Enchantment is my pick as the best perk as it allows you to free yourself from being caged, but use it carefully as Bonky may be nearby. Now the thing I see the most among new players is wasting stamina. Do not carelessly use stamina as you may encounter Bonky around a corner and have nowhere to run off to, leading to you being caged or eliminated. It's best to walk around the map and only use stamina when hiding from or avoiding Bonky. And also worth mentioning that survivors will make a loud breathing sound when they finish sprinting a long distance, so make sure you've gotten far enough away or spent little stamina. A small but helpful piece of information is having every generator spawn memorized. There are 3 spawn locations for all 5 generators. Yellow can spawn behind the carousel, in front of the carousel, and outside the green tent near the carousel. 2 green spawns are inside the hay maze, 1 behind the hay maze, 2 white spawns by the truck outside the blue cafeteria tent, another next to the mini tents outside the cafeteria, purple spawns by the haystack near the slide attraction, left of the slide, and behind the slide, blue in front of Bonky's big wheel, and both sides of the wheel. Another small tip would be sliding. There are little hills and slopes scattered throughout the map that you can slide down, gaining a little speed boost which can help you rotate to different generators or escape Bonky at the cost of around 7 stamina due to the requirement of sprinting before sliding. The last tip I have for you is what I call vendor juking. This trick has recently been removed in a certain spot that made it impossible for Bonky to hit you. Luckily, there are other spots that are almost as good as it, such as the vendor near purple generator. What you essentially do is hop onto the platform and go around in circles while Bonky is chasing you. Each time Bonky chases you around, he will be forced to slow down by the hay obstacle, allowing you to create some space between Bonky and make your escape. There are 9 platform vendors around the map, so make good use of them. In my opinion, this works better on screen than VR, as third-person view covers a wider area to keep track on Bonky easier. That's gonna be it for this video. If any of you have important tips or techniques, go ahead and leave it in the comments and I'll check them out. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and leave a like, and I'll see you next time.